miles off the coast of Newfoundland. Captain Scotty Drabinowitz and the Eagle Eye 2 are on the fish and on the money. But Scotty's mind is elsewhere.
This truly does suck here because of this Hurricane Igor coming.
Big storm, man.
The weather is clear and sunny today. To the south, Hurricanes Igor and Julia are closing in on the fleet.
Big hurricanes are definitely a serious issue, not to take lightly. They can kill you.
With a gale diameter of 920 miles, Igor is the largest storm ever recorded in the Atlantic Basin.
If you look at the size of this storm, it's basically as high and as long as the whole eastern seaboard.
And the double-barrel hurricane is primed to roll through the North Atlantic in a deadly repeat of 1991's perfect storm.
We need to really come up with a game plan if we have to move, if we're going to stay and ride it out. You know, hurricanes do a lot of weird things. We're not sure what we're going to do. Yeah, right now we're doing what we normally would do. We're just fishing.
Ooh, he jumped.
Ooh. Swordfish!
The Grand Banks are some of the richest fishing grounds on Earth.
Yeah, baby!
Each fall, boats from around the world gather to seek their fortune catching giant swordfish.
Come on down!
Swordfish for the collection.
Yeah, that's a keeper.
Woo! My fish.
Double marker!
This 200-pound sword, called a double marker, could be worth up to $1,000. Finally, the last hooks come up.
We have a little trip on the boat, but it's not why we really come out here. We don't come out here for a little trip. We come out here for big trips to make big money.
Setting another 40 miles of gear could bring in enough to cover the boat's expenses and turn a profit for the crew. But with the massive storm bearing down, Captain Scotty would be risking more than money.
Don't look like it's gonna be too pretty here. Come in.
Scotty checks the weather reports with other captains in the fleet.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Yeah, when go on to the 21st, that's when the hits the fan. Where we are on the morning of the 21st, it's not too hard to scroll around and find 60 knots on just with your cursor.
The fate and finances of the Eagle Eye 2 rest on the captain's next move.
Hey, guys. Well, you probably know the storm's coming, right? And all like that. I'm pretty sure you heard the radio on. It just trips over. We're going in.
The Eagle Eye 2 will steam for the safety of the Bay Bulls Harbor. But leaving money on the table is hard to swallow.
The folks that run away in now because of the hurricane, we just got on the fish.
We're disappointed, you know. We were definitely picking our way to a decent trip. So it would have been that much more money for the guys. And that's disappointing, because that's what we come out here for. But the bottom line is to keep the crew and the boat safe.
50 miles northeast, Captain Chompers has no decision to make. His 58-foot fiberglass boat is undersized for the Grand Banks in the best of conditions.
Igor is moving toward the northeast. Maximum sustained winds remain near 75 miles per hour, with higher gusts. Igor is a Category 1 hurricane. Some strengthening is possible.
Where's everybody at, Woody? Everybody at back. Things have took a change on the fishing vessel Big Eye. We're no longer going to the Grand Banks. We're looking at about 140 knot winds, maybe 42 to 43 foot waves. It's big.
Yeah.
It's bigger than the United States. It's huge. It's the biggest storm that I've seen on a weather map since I've been in my fishing career.
I'd rather be tied up and have something that come over top of me and I would out in that ocean.
So we're gonna go to the dock and seek safe harbor.
You gotta do what you gotta do. You can't fool Mother Nature.
That's about all I got to say. I mean, it is what it is, and decisions made, and we're headed for trespasses.
The Big Eye will steam for shore, hoping to dodge the biggest hurricane the Grand Banks has ever seen.
The forecast has got it moving pretty fast at this point. It's kind of moving around. It's kind of following us. Everything's just leaning against us right now. Things are not good. Conditions ain't good. Captain ain't good. Fish hole ain't no good.
The hurricane decided to come this way and decided to hang out. Really stirred things up out here to where we couldn't fish for a while. We all would.
The Grand Banks provides the best sword fishing in the world because of the intersection of the cold Labrador Current and the warm Gulf Stream. If the storm lingers here, those conditions could be destroyed.
It doesn't take much wind or weather to change everything, and we just got dealt a pretty bad hand here.
Just a week after steaming out, with only one set of fish on the boat, the Big Eye is leaving the Grand Banks.
That's fishing. That's just the way it is. Just when you think you got it figured out, you figure out you don't.
Pretty much gonna suck for all of us. It's really gonna cost us some time. Definitely not the way you want to start a fishing trip.
75 miles southwest. Captain Linda Greenlaw is hauling up her fourth set of the season.
Looks like a sword.
This 200-pound double marker will bring them $1,000 closer to covering expenses and turning a profit.
I just wish we didn't have this weather bearing down on us. We could stay, you know. It's starting to believe this hurricane coming looking at this, but you know they say the calm before the storm, right? I guess this is it.
Setting another 40 miles of mainline could pay off, but it would mean another 24 hours in the path of the storm.
We had a big decision to make. If we stayed here, we could fish tonight. But then I wonder if I'd regret it, you know, if the weather really, really is awful. Going in would have been the right thing. It's hard to, one of those decisions that captains are faced with all the time.
Let us be for the day.
We need to get north of this storm, or at least out of its path. It seems like it's tracking right for us, like we are the bullseye. I've plotted a course for Newfoundland.
Like Scotty and Chompers, Linda will head for shore.
How bad is the weather supposed to be?
Well, right now they're still calling for 85 knots of wind. So pretty bad, and it's a big system. You know, they're giving 10-meter seas even out 500 miles from the center of the storm, so it's a gigantic system. So it pretty much gives us today. Let's try and get everything battened down today, make sure everything's good and secure. Everything has to be lashed down. If we get a lot of water on deck and we lose control of this engine in the middle of a storm, that's the worst case scenario. Well, we'll have a big mess. That's it. That's all I have for you.
We're battening down the hatches for the hurricane.
Just
taking that up.
We're losing about 3 days of fishing.
You know, every day we're not fishing, it's costing us money.
Now the deck's all secure, now we can get ready for our Newfoundland power washer.
20 years ago, the Hannah Bowden survived the perfect storm. Now, another double-barrel hurricane is taking aim at the Grand Banks. And Captain Greenlaw knows better than to let her guard down.
I'm always concerned that the weather is going to do something different than what is forecast. You know, it's weather. It's like fishing. Really, as much as we try to predict things, it's still Mother Nature. She can still change her mind at the last minute and do something different.
Coming up.
Robin's low at 60 right now.
Captain Greenlaw gets blindsided.
I think we're gonna need a bigger boat.
And Hurricane Igor shows no mercy. Oh. 24 hours after leaving the fishing grounds, the Eagle Eye 2 is the first boat to reach shelter in Bay Bulls Harbor.
You know what's the good thing about it? We're about 20 minutes away from dry land and being safe.
Although they beat the storm to the docks, powerful gusts race through the bay. Last season, the Eagle Eye 2 barely survived trying to dock in Bay Bulls.
Welcome to the North Atlantic.
The crew scrambles to tie off quickly as 50-knot winds threaten to wrench the boat off the dock.
Careful. Hold that line! Damn it! Come on!
Hold that line!
The way the wind's blowing and everything, I mean, it's just going to blow us right into them boats. And this is a big 150-ton steel boat. And that's a nice little wooden boat. That wooden boat's going to lose in a push come to shove match.
Come on! That's it! 1, 2, 3, 4! Come on!
Finally, the winds die down, just enough for the crew to secure the boat.
Safe and sound, snug as a bug in a rug. We're ready to rock and roll.
...250 miles from the safety of Bay Bulls.
Testing the safety.
The Hannah Bowden is the furthest boat in the fleet from land. Still 10 hours away from shelter.
What's the update? What's the news?
Linda gets on the phone for one last weather update from the boat's owner.
Those two hurricanes that we're tracking, they've come together. And what they're saying is it's headed for Newfoundland.
The news is not good. The hurricanes have changed course. And while on her way to safety, Linda is trapped between them.
So we left the fishing grounds to go to Newfoundland to get out of its path. And now, of course, the weather has, changed its mind. So right now we're kind of going to plan C, which is dealing with the fact that we are steaming towards where the weather is going. If I had a crystal ball, I could really make a good decision, but I don't have one.
20 years after surviving the perfect storm, another massive hurricane has backed Captain Greenlaw into a corner.
We're on the Grand Banks. The storm's gonna run us over. We go to Newfoundland, the storm's gonna run us over. I think I'm a hurricane magnet.
And as the wind begins to howl, the ghosts of 1991 weigh heavy on the captain's mind.
What was tragically unique about it was that a boat very near and dear to me went down, all hands lost, and seemingly without a trace. Things happen at sea. Mother Nature can be brutal.
With the massive storm blocking her path to safety, and the fate of the crew in her hands. Captain Linda makes the call.
I've made a decision to return to the fishing grounds.
As the sun rises over the Grand Banks, all that's left to do is wait for the storm and pray the captain made the right decision.
Will I go down at sea? Don't know. If I do, rest assured, I probably screwed up. I probably did something wrong.
250 miles to the west, the docks at Bay Bulls are not the safe haven that Captain Scotty was hoping for. Scotty's plan to sell his fish today gets put on hold.
Right now, we can't. We were supposed to offload today, but it's so bad on the west coast wind, man. Air comes right out of the north. Feel it? Well, it's going to start howling here in just a little bit. We wanted to get the fish off today. We wanted to get the boat all ready to get going. We want to leave as soon as we can leave. But it's so bad on the western part of Newfoundland here right now that the roads are washed out and the trucks can't even go.
At any moment, the brute strength of a Category 4 storm will be right on top of them.
Oh yeah, the weather's boss here right now, and it's really gonna get going. Here we go. Well, it's gonna be blowing 60 here in a few minutes.
Back down the hatches, and here it comes.
While the storm batters the Newfoundland shoreline, out on the open waters of the Grand Banks, the Hannah boat braces for the worst.
We're just riding it out. We really don't have any other option right now. It's ride out the storm.
We got like 60 knots of wind now, probably 20-foot seas. Getting pretty nasty.
Miles from the coast of Newfoundland, in the middle of the Grand Banks, Hurricane Igor pummels the Hannah boat. Knot winds threaten to rip the cover off the boat's ice machine. If the ice maker gets fouled with salt water, this trip is over. No more ice means no more fish and no more paycheck. Weather report brings more dire news.
Again, the storm has changed course. We left the fishing grounds because the storm was going to run over where we were. We're going to go to Newfoundland. Oh, the storm changed course. Now Igor is going right for Newfoundland. So we head offshore again. The eye is heading right for us. So I truly am the hurricane magnet. We're at sea waiting for a hurricane to run over the top of us.
...300 miles to the northwest. At Trepassey Harbor, Captain Chompers and the Big Eye are taking a beating.
It's howling behind. It's probably blowing 60 right now. We got the wind coming from the northeast. Getting pretty right now.
Struggles to add more lines and secure the boat against 90 knot winds. Keeps the engine in gear and under throttle, desperately trying to keep tension off the lines. Too much tension, and the ropes will snap, sending the boat careening out of control.
He's nervous as hell. We're the closest boat to the rocks, so if anything breaks loose, we'll be on the rocks for sure.
The wind kicks up over 100 knots.
Watch that cleat right here. Look, blowing so hard, it's been blowing our metal up. I think got 4, 6, 8 volts in it. It's still pulling that metal up because of the storm.
And the crew frantically tries to keep the stern attached to the dock. In Trepassey, Newfoundland, Hurricane Igor pounds the fishing vessel Big Eye. Cleat holding the rope to the dock snaps off, nearly taking Woody's hand with it. Threatening to destroy the boat, there's no time to deal with a medical emergency. Woody has no choice but to man up and keep working to save the ship. Scrambles to run new lines from the boat to the dock. Anything to keep the Big Eye from breaking free.
Oh, watch out! Jeff! Careful, man!
Miles to the southeast. Cut off from the mainland, Captain Greenlaw and the Hannah Bowden brave the storm alone.
Well, I can go wrong with the weather like this.
I think we're gonna need a bigger boat.
Similar, brings back memories back in 1991 in October. We're up here fishing. I was fishing with Linda on this boat. It was back, they called it the perfect storm. It was a real bad storm. We got caught all in gear that day. I was there by that hatch just after butchering a fish. This boat took a big roll wave over the starboard side. Handle there, this boat made such a roll, there was about 4 feet of water come over that wall, filled all this deck right there from the top of that wall right over that hatch, filled all that corner. I was looking over like that, this boat was on a list like this. I was looking straight up at that outrigger, that was straight up in the air. I thought we were gone, I thought we were doomed. That she hesitated for like 5-6 seconds and she finally come back. Miserable day. We got our asses kicked. Unfortunately, those poor guys on the Andrew Gill, they got hit the storm way, way worse than us. Linda was last to talk to Billy Tyne. Billy said, she's coming on strong, boys. That's the last we heard tell of that guy, poor guys. Out here, like you get in bad storms like this.
Up at the wheelhouse.
We've done some damage to the cart house and taken a couple big shots on the windows. I just don't want to take the windows out and don't want to do any more damage.
Howl at 110 knots and waves surge to 40 feet.
Mother Nature packs a punch, that's for sure.
Mother Nature is showing her stuff. You know, we're getting pretty comfortable there, nice weather, picking up a few fish. And in the back of our minds, we're thinking, we're going to pay for this. And here we are, paying in full.
This screaming, boys. Screaming.
in Trepassey Harbor, Newfoundland. Hurricane Igor thrashes Captain Chompers and the Big Eye.
Boat's getting destroyed. I got to go. If I lose the boat right now, I got to go.
20-foot waves blast the tiny fiberglass boat, threatening to break it in two.
Getting beat up pretty bad up here by the dock like this.
Polyballs, normally used as buoys, get put into service as chafing gear to protect the hull.
It's pretty bad right here, I'm telling you, man.
By 4 p.m., the brutal wind finally subsides, and the crew of the Big Eye surveys the damage.
Cleat broke off the stern of the boat. It hit me right in my hand, right across my palm of my hand, right here. I got lucky I didn't lose my hand.
What is more than lucky that it happened like it did? His hand was just barely touching it.
It could have probably broke his arm off, killed him. Ain't no telling.
I just need to get me a set of steel arms so I can't break nothing no more.
Dawn breaks over Newfoundland as Hurricane Igor dissipates far to the north. Still tied to the dock in Bay Bulls is the Eagle Eye 2.
Oh, boat was fine as kind. We were on the inside of the dock. We fared just wonderful. You know, come out of it without a scratch, which is great. You know, that was the name of the game. We succeeded.
Now it's time for Scotty and his crew to get paid. With few swordfish coming in due to the storm, today's price is a good one, $5 a pound.
And what happens is the guys will be taking fish out this way, okay, putting them on the deck, and then the boom truck will swing across, pick up the fish, put them on the truck where the scale is. They'll be weighed, and then they'll be put in boxes.
Send them back to the States, make a couple bucks, head back out, make some more money.
Ooh, here's a nice one. I bet that fish is 300 pounds, or damn close to it.
Oh, yeah, beautiful fish. Hopefully get a little money from it.
A 300-pound swordfish, known as a triple marker, should be worth at least $1,500.
Swordfish out of the hold.
Here comes the quad. Four banger.
Yeah.
Maybe. We'll see.
Last week, Tommy Fox battled a monster swordfish on the live line.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah.
And now, that giant is ready for market.
Yeah. There you want some in?
Don't stand under him.
I think he's bigger than me.
Well, we're going to find out real soon how big that fish is. Simple as that. You're going to take the guesswork out of it in a little while.
498.
Young kid on the boat calls it 498. Let's see how close he is. He said 498. What do you say?
410.
410? Nah, bigger than 410, I'll tell you that.
Hey, Brian, send the big one up.
Is anybody holding that in the way or something? Go down a little bit.
$492. How much?
$492.
You were close, Brian. $492.
Yeah. Thank you.
This huge fish will bring in nearly $2,500.
Awesome fish.
And better yet, it puts Scotty one up on the competition.
That fish right there is still bigger than, I hate to say it, it's still bigger than any fish that Linda's caught so far in the last couple of seasons.
The Eagle Eye 2 makes just over $100,000 for this short trip. After the expenses of gear, bait, and food are covered, the captain takes half the profit, with the rest divvied up equally among the crew.
Go back out and hit it again.
But this is just the beginning of a long and risky season, and Hurricane Igor has cost them valuable fishing time.
We don't make any money sitting at the dock. Doesn't mean we're going to make money when we go offshore, but at least we got a chance to make money. We have no chance of making money sitting here.
Coming up.
And I really thought that I was going to lose my boat. Yes. Yes.
The effects of Hurricane Igor wreak havoc on the fleet.
All of this bad weather has really broken up the water that we were fishing. Not to make anybody panic, but fish are going to be hard to come by.
...7 a.m., Trepassey, Newfoundland. Tied up dockside, Captain Chompers and the Big Eye.
Because I really thought that I was going to lose my boat. Yes. Yes. Because if the rope broke, we'd be on the rocks. I weren't coming out of there. There weren't no way I was going to get this boat away from the dock without breaking it in half. Impossible. And if I had half, my boat would have been gone. We wouldn't have had no boat. We'd have been up there in that motel this morning, trying to get the boat salvaged off the rocks. It's beat pieces of sunk right there. Just like that. $350,000.
The boat survived, but paid a heavy price in lost time and an injury that nearly ended Woody's season.
Yeah, we're securing the deck. We're going to be getting out of here in just a little bit. Thank God.
Woody, come on, help me get the boat untied.
I hope I don't pull this rope out for at least 12 or 13 days. That means we'll have a trip on here, hopefully.
3 weeks into the season, the Big Eye has only set their gear once. With just 2,100 pounds in the hold, the Big Eye is firmly planted in last place, with Scotty and Slick battling for the top spot.
Definitely excited to get going. Been here too long, so ready to go.
We're behind eight ball. We need to get going.
The Big Eye took a beating, but the smallest boat in the fleet is still standing.
I probably aged 20 years yesterday, but now the smoke's clear. We're going to go out here and catch some fish and deal with what the next obstacle Mother Nature has for us.
Oh, yeah, back on the water. Go make some money. Enough of this land stuff. We need to be out there.
Once again, the Big Eye's been dealt a tough hand.
I don't know what's going to happen. I'm going to have to find a different place, a different tactic to catch fish. It's going to be hard. I'm outclassed, outboat, outsized.
Odds are against me. Got a lot of pressure on me.
But Captain Chompers may just have one more ace up his sleeve.
I'm probably going to come up with a unique plan where I can be where I can make me a big pot of chicken salad out of chicken is what I'm going to try to do. And I'm going to convince everybody that it's good and everybody's going to want a sandwich. That's what I'm going to try to do.
...300 miles off the coast of Newfoundland. Having weathered the storm at sea, Captain Linda and the Hannah Bowden are the first of the fleets back on the fishing grounds and the first in line to make a fat paycheck.
Getting ready to go fishing tonight. Try to make some money again.
The Hannah Bowden is the only boat ready to throw their gear. All Linda has to do is find the fish.
There is a distinct possibility that all of this bad weather has really broken up the water that we were fishing, and it may take a while for it to come back together. I'm looking for a place where the temperature might be similar to what we had before the hurricane. And before the hurricane, I was fishing 61 to 66 degrees. Without that temperature gradient, that break to set the gear on, fish are going to be hard to come by.
Thanks to the hurricane, the crew hasn't had hooks in the water for nearly a week.
Time to go make some money. Sick of sitting around watching hurricanes.
I'm ready to go fishing. Get this trip done, get to the dock, offload, make some money. Fishing for a paycheck, not fishing for fun.
Linda's plan? Set the gear out immediately and beat the other boats to the Swordfish.
Waiting for the temperature gauge to go up. Staring at the temperature gauge, just like watching a pot. That's what we're doing. 61 going once. Oh, going twice. Oh, went down to 60. Went down 100. Come on.
But if she can't find water temperature of at least 61 degrees, the advantage of being on the fishing grounds first will quickly slip away.
Not to make anybody panic, but I once waited 2 days for 2 degrees. It's painful. This is painful, staring at the temperature gauge, waiting for it to go up. Talk to it, Carl. Talk to it.
61. I'm ready to go.
Somebody might have just flushed the toilet, so it went up a couple degrees.
The Hannah Bowden survived the pounding of Hurricane Igor. Now, the pressure is on to cash in.
This is high season for swordfish, so I'm hoping that the hurricane hasn't screwed that up, because if it has, it's going to be a really short and probably not a real profitable season for us.